Erev Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. An array of news topics this evening that are going on all over the world, starting with Israel. A 60-year-old man, estimated to be 60 years old, has been stabbed by the Lion's Gate in the old city there in Jerusalem. This just happened only about an hour or so ago. We had some video footage here to kind of give you an idea of what's going on there in the old city there. Just to see the chaos that was ensuing there. The terrorist that did this, the knife-wielding man that stabbed him multiple times in the chest there, some reports say he was in serious conditions. Others are saying that he is moderately wounded there. But this terrorist did get away. The police have pursued him on foot, but as of yet, no one has been able to find the terrorist suspect there. Let's pray that they do happen to find him before too long there. Another thing that is going on, and this is an older article here from 2014, but on CT24 News in the Czech Republic, that is in Prague, they were reporting tonight that the United States and the Czech Republic may be nearing a deal to allow food imports into the Czech Republic. Now, I don't know about all the European Union, but the Czech Republic is talking about doing that. And lawmakers were debating tonight on television only moments ago, within the last 10 minutes, about trying to stop the United States food from coming into the country. As lawmakers were saying on Czech CT24 News, they were saying that the genetically modified food in the United States is dangerous and hazardous to the health of human beings, and that that it should not be allowed in the Czech Republic. But yet, there is a large push to allow this food into the country. Now, this article here from July 6th of 2014, Why Does Europe Hate GM Food? And it's about to change its mind. Was stating here that while the United States, Canada, Brazil, Argentina, China, and many other countries have many warmly embraced genetically modified crops, Europe remains the world's biggest holdout. Could this be about to change? New European Union rules now seek to clear up years of internal deadlock that could, in theory, lead to widespread cultivation of GM foods, but the fight is far from over. Well, it looks like that fight may very well be nearing an end. But then again, what can you expect? Because also going on in Prague, Czech Republic, we have two visitors here today in the Czech Republic. That is the Vice President of Iran, Mr. Saleh, and also the nuclear chief Ali Akbar Saleh. And in addressing the media's press conference in Prague, Czech Republic, but also Lumar Zarolek, who's on the right, that's the vice president of Iran, and of course the man on the left there is a nuclear chief for Iran. They're meeting here in the Czech Republic today, but it's an unspecified reasoning for furthering cooperation on nuclear power, energy sources, things of that nature there. But what's kind of strange is it's unspecified. Now, of course, the Czech Republic is solely dependent upon nuclear-powered energy for the country's needs. They do solar power as well as windmill-driven power in the country as well. A lot of homes also have solar power, which is not the best thing in the world for the Czech Republic because we have more cloudy days than we have sunshiny days. But the Czech Republic is looking to build more nuclear reactors in the country for its ever-growing electrical needs there. So why is the nuclear chief and the vice president of Iran in the Czech Republic? They're looking to further ties, economic ties, in this particular industry here. So since the lifting of the sanctions, they're expecting to really be able to move further ahead. You can only wonder and speculate what might come out of this particular meeting. Also, on the Russian Insider, they are reporting a very not very good news. NATO wants to put German troops on the Russian border, a move that isn't going to go down well either Germany or Russia. This just came out only a minute ago. The Wall Street Journal is reporting today that NATO is preparing to deploy 4 battalions, approximately 4,000 troops. We're aware of that. We shared that with our broadcast just yesterday. But it says, to Russia's western border, U.S. Deputy Secretary of Defense Robert Work was in Brussels today to announce the western military escalation on Russia's border, which he claimed was in response to Russian military exercises near the Baltic countries of Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. According to the Deputy Secretary of Defense Work, 2 of the battalions would come from the United States, with 1 each coming from the UK and Germany. This announcement might come as news to German lawmakers, as much as a significant German military presence on Russia's border is not been approved by Berlin. Although German Chancellor Angela Merkel has given Washington reason to believe that Germany would join the escalation. The move is considered highly controversial in a Germany growing weary of following U.S. foreign policy and dictates. In fact, according to the recent polling, only 1 in 3 Germans supports the idea of German military defending the Baltics, even if there were a Russian attack. A clear majority of Germans oppose NATO military bases on Russia's border. It's kind of an interesting side note there. Not to mention the other issue, too, that you have to remember is that there's a lot of hard feelings between Germany and Russia from the Second World War. So many Russians were killed in that war. Of course, well as were Germans, they were killed on both sides. Both sides suffered heavy casualties, but there's always been a little bit of a bad taste in the mouth with Russia there for the heavy losses it sustained and pushing back Adolf Hitler. And even today in the Ukraine, that was the toppling of the Ukrainian government there that now is led by Poroshenko, the president of the country now, has been done chiefly in part by neo-Nazi groups that were brought in, according to Russia, in their documentary, Crimea, The Way Home, that they stated in there that it was U.S. CIA-backed neo-Nazis that overthrew the government. So there's a lot of tensions there for Germany to be there. Germany doesn't want to be there, according to this particular article here from the Russian Insider. So we'll have to wait and see how things play out on that there. RT News, though, has put out an article that is definitely going to raise some hair on the back of some people's necks, especially in light of the fear of Planet X. 3 new Earth-sized planets offer best chance of finding life beyond the solar system. That is a dwarf star, by the way, in the background there. And the reason why I say it will raise a lot of questions is because they say there are some planets that are orbiting this. They say it's 40 or 50 light years outside of our, 40 light years from Earth is where this particular exoplanets are orbiting around a nearly ultra-cool dwarf star, some 40 light years from Earth. And by the way, if Planet X really is traveling, as the Chilean scientists stated, nearly in its elliptical orbit, at one particular point, it's supposed to have a speed nearly like half, 50% of the speed of light or something like that. I forget exactly the details on that. But the point being, is this really 40 light years from Earth? Could that dwarf star there that they're showing, and I'm sure, assuming this is just a mock picture here, but could that dwarf star actually be Planet X, and it's a little bit closer than what we think there? It's just kind of interesting that RT News is bringing this out. Says a team of astronomers have discovered 3 new exoplanets orbiting around a nearby ultra-cool dwarf star, some 40 light years from Earth. Details of the planet were outlined in a research published in the journal Nature and show how Earth-sized planets were detected by a Belgian robotic telescope based in Chile. Also known as TROPPIST-1, the dwarf star is considered to be part of the Earth's neighborhood and is believed to be 500 million years old, with a cooler temperature than the sun. Michael Gillian, one of the authors of the study, said the dwarf stars such as a TROPPIST-1 are common in the Milky Way, but this is the first time the planets have been tracked in the vicinity of one of them. Very interesting indeed. Could this be that elusive Planet X that everybody has been wondering about, coming closer and closer to our solar system? Anyway, hard to say. Who knows what's going to happen next, but one thing's for sure, things are sure ramping up awfully quick all over the world and around the globe. News happening everywhere. In Australia today, at a refugee center there, a woman set herself on fire in protest, trying to commit suicide in protest to the conditions that's going on in Australia. All kinds of things are happening globally. There's just no way one person keep up with everything. You guys, I'm sure, are aware of that. Check out our Facebook page. Like it there if you like that. There is Israeli News Live on Facebook. There's many, many people that go there. We have thousands of visitors, and there's always a lot more news that we load on our Facebook page with Israeli News Live. Anyway, God bless you. Thank you for watching. Keep us posted if you happen to see any news going on out there. You can send us an email at stephenbenoon@aol.com or go to israelinewslive.org. The contact information there where you can email us directly from the website will go directly to us in our inbox as well. If I haven't been able to answer you on any of the emails, be patient with me there. We do get a huge amount of emails there, but we will get back with you just as soon as we can. Shalom. God bless you.